been working for the battleship for 32 years. What happened, a friend of mine, he got the job, and what he did it for like 5.5 years, and he was going to college in the daytime and taking flying lessons, and he got a job basically babysitting the battleship at night. He would come in at about 5 in the afternoon, 6 days a week, and he would, closing time, he'd cut the lights off, yank the flags down, set the alarms, and he actually slept on the ship all night and got up the next morning and opened the place up and called it a day. He's a good friend of mine. I used to come here and hang out with him all the time, and I told him whenever he left that I wanted a job. And so he said, I'll let you know. And so sure enough, he left. During the time that I used to come here and hang out with him, every once in a while he would sort of hint around about some unusual activity, and I didn't really pay him too much attention. And what happened, he called me up one night and he said, listen, he said, I got me a job flying. He said, I want you to come over here. I got some things to tell you about the job. And I said, okay. So I come over, and he said, you know, he said, we've talked about, you mentioned about how easy the job is. He said, Danny, it's not really that easy. And I said, what do you mean, break-ins or something? He said, no. He said, it's haunted. And I started laughing at him. I said, what are you talking about? He said, about 3 or 4 nights out of the year, he said, he'll slam doors behind you. You'll hear him running down passageways at night. He'll move things in the room. He said, Danny, he said, I've had encounters with him, and there's probably at least 10 other people working here have had encounters. He said, sometimes it happens at night, and sometimes it happens in the daytime. And, of course, I started laughing at him because I thought he was just, you know, making all that up to scare me because he knew I'd be over here at night by myself. And about 10 months into the job, I found out he was telling me the truth. I've had so many encounters through the years. Ship and family stayed on me about writing about it. So what happened about, it's been about 7 years now. It took about a year to do it. I finally decided to go ahead and do it, and I wrote and published this book called Ghosts on the Battleship North Carolina. It was edited by Bonnie White, who's a local author writer, and I actually wrote and published it for my niece. Her name is Cheryl, and she's like my daughter, and so actually the part of the proceeds go into a trust fund type thing for her in the future. And what it is 13 ghost stories. 11 of these are my own personal stories, and 2 of them are friends of mine had encounters, and it tells what happened.